Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Good morning to our friends at The Rundown. Here are the top stories in the North American region.
We begin the new year with fresh indications of a long war in the Middle East. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says his country's campaign against Hamas would take many more months. His remarks followed intensified attacks by Israeli forces on central Gaza, killing at least 10 people and driving more to flee the area to the Rafah border with Egypt. Hamas militants, in response, fired a barrage of rockets into central Israel at the stroke of midnight, which the group says was in response to Israel's massacre against civilians. In New York, the final hours of 2023 saw new protests in the city in support of Palestinians. Protesters converged in midtown Manhattan expressing support for Palestine. Next, we head to California, where a new giant mural made by a Filipino goes on display at the Long Beach International Airport. The 60-by-30 piece of art was created by PhilAm artist Marconi Calindas Cafege. The mural is on display on the facade of one of the airport's parking structures in celebration of the airport's centennial anniversary.
Really overwhelming, and I am just amazed knowing that, you know, I represent the Filipinos from around the world, and of course here in the U.S., as a Filipino-American, I am very proud.
The mural showcases the distinct features of Long Beach from its history in aviation to diverse art and culture. Sister Cynthia and Rose, both Long Beach locals, say having the mural created by a Filipino is like paying homage to Philippine heritage and the city they love.
Well, I think the Filipino touch is the happiness that's in it, his colors, how he blends everything together. It's just, that is what we're about.
It's very unique, and it's colorful because the city is colorful. Our Long Beach is very diversified.
And finally, entertainment, the world of The Boys expands with its hit spin-off Gen V, which introduces TV fans to characters from the superhero-only college, Godalkin University. The new Amazon series stars Derek Liu and London Thor, who both play Jordan Lee, an outstanding student endowed with the unique ability of changing between male and female forms. Lou shares a recent fan encounter that shows how Jordan has quickly become a fan favorite.
Don't say it, I'm gonna get it. And she gets up, leaves, and then comes back and she's like, Gen V, you're the one who plays two people. And I'm like, oh, thank you so much. I play one version and then another amazing actress plays another version. She's like, you ruined the magic.
And those are the stories making the headlines. For more of our TFC News, log on to our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFCnews. Head over to the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel and download the ABS-CBN News app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manotok. Back to our friends at The Rundown.
Israel signaling a new face in its nearly three-month-long war in Gaza. A day after announcing it will pull out thousands of troops from the Strip, Israel now says residents in its town near Gaza will be allowed to return home soon.
In accordance with the recommendations given by the IDF and the defense establishment, we will soon be able to return displaced communities home in areas within a range of 4 to 7 kilometers north of the Gaza Strip. The first group of 7 communities has already been decided, and they have received the message. Kibbutz Dorot, where we are right now, is one of them. The National Reconstruction Administration, which is responsible for this national mission, will handle the issue of education and other issues, so a gradual return will be possible. In the first stage, 7 communities, and going forward, all the rest of the communities.
Despite the supposed shift to lower intensity operations, fighting in central parts of Gaza continue. Since October 7, nearly 22,000 Palestinians have been killed in the war. Its Supreme Court overturns a highly contested law aimed at weakening the powers of the judiciary. The law passed by Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's government had removed the Supreme Court's ability to quash decisions by Israeli authorities. It was a part of a broader judicial overhaul proposed by Netanyahu and his allies, which sparked concerns over the country's democratic principles. The aftermath of the powerful quake that struck Japan on New Year's Day. At least 6 people killed after the magnitude 7.5 tremor hit the Ishikawa Prefecture, destroying buildings, knocking out power lines, and prompting thousands of residents in coastal areas to flee to higher ground. The quake triggered waves as high as 1 meter along Japan's seaboard and in South Korea. Japan issued a major tsunami warning, the first since 2011. It has since been lifted, but advisories remain. Aftershocks may also continue for days. Japan authorities, meanwhile, assure the public no irregularities have been detected at the nuclear plants following the massive quake. There were no reported damage at the Shika nuclear plant, the closest to the epicenter. Damage assessment will continue, with more aftershocks expected in the coming days. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department activates a hotline for Filipinos affected by the powerful quake in Japan. Those seeking assistance or information about their Filipino relatives may reach out to the DMW's Japan Help Desk through the numbers flashed on your screens. There are nearly 300,000 Filipinos living in Japan, with about 1,300 residing in the Ishikawa Prefecture. U.S. President Joe Biden offers assistance to Japan. In a statement, Biden said, as close allies, Washington stands ready to provide any necessary assistance for Tokyo. He adds his administration is in touch with Japanese officials as they continue to respond to the disaster. Over in New York City, at least 8 people were injured after a motorist crashed his car into a restaurant in Manhattan. The incident took place just a few blocks south of Times Square, where New Year festivities were coming to a close after midnight. The driver was allegedly fleeing a dispute in a black Mercedes before striking several police vehicles and injuring several pedestrians. The driver is facing several charges. Chinese leader Xi Jinping rings in the new year with a rare admission that China's economy is in trouble. In his televised New Year speech, Xi said, "Some Chinese enterprises are struggling and some people have difficulty finding jobs and meeting basic needs." This is the first time Xi said mentioned the economic challenges in his annual New Year's messages since he started giving them in 2013. But she says policymakers will work to strengthen the momentum of China's economic recovery.